The Bible says in this part two that in the book of 1 Samuel, 30th chapter, and in the 7th verse, let's go to the 6th verse, and David was greatly distressed, for the people spake of stoning him, because the soul of all the people was grieved, every man for his sons and for his daughters. When David encouraged himself in the Lord his God, he knew who he was serving. The Bible says, "Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves." There comes a time in your life where you have to enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. You are going to have to be thankful and bless his name. Why? Because the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting. His truth endures to all generations. You are a royal priesthood. You're a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people. Why? That you should show forth the praises of God that has called you out of darkness into this marvelous light. The word of the Lord comes up close and personal. You know why? Because God has decided in your life enough has to be enough. He's heard your cry. He's seen your tears. He feels your heartache and he feels your pain. Have you ever had something taken? David was out fighting another man's war, trying to help somebody else. Have you ever even heard of a situation where you're trying to help everybody else and you need help and there's nobody to help you? Well, God sees all of that. And now he's saying, "I'm coming to help you." And that right early. But while he's coming to help you, you've got to encourage yourself in the Lord. The Bible says, "Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up, ye everlasting doors." And the Bible says the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. I want you to know today, you have to encourage yourself. It's going to be all right. You have to pat yourself on the shoulder. Say your name. Pat yourself on the shoulder. And Sandra is my name. Sandra, everything is going to be all right. I know God's going to fix it. I know God is going to bring me out. The Bible says, "Offer unto God sacrifices of praise, which is the fruit of your lips." You've got to open up your mouth. No matter how hard it seems, you might be in the kitchen listening to this word, and you're saying, "God, I called you. I called you, Lord, but there's no answer." You know what? God said, "Call unto me, and I will answer thee. And I will show you great and mighty things that you don't even know not." That's how good God is. Let me tell you what David did. The Bible says, "And David inquired at the Lord, saying, Shall I pursue after this truth? Shall I overtake them? And he answered, Pursue, for thou shalt surely overtake them, and without fail recover all."
Don't let it change your mind. God will be God, yes. Oh.